In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how I shoot and edit my YouTube videos, including all the equipment and software I use to bring you this exact content you're watching right now. Hey friends, I'm Tasia and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. Today we are doing a deep dive not only into how I shoot and edit my YouTube videos, but I'm gonna go over my complete YouTube setup and equipment. But wait, there's more. I'm gonna show you exactly how I plan and organize my YouTube content. We have a lot to cover, so let's go. All right, let's start from the beginning planning stages so you know my exact process. I use Google Drive to plan and organize all of my YouTube videos. Bet you didn't see that one coming. Why do I love Google Drive? Let me count thy ways. In short, it's free and it's easily searchable across their suite of apps. It really helps me stay organized. I've got a million and one videos linked below on Google Drive, so I'm not gonna get into all of the benefits of Google Drive here. Specifically for this video, I'm going to cover what I use, which is Google Docs, Google Sheets, and Google Calendar. So first comes the planning. What do I want to shoot? What type of content ideas do I think will be good? When do I want to release those specific content ideas? And so on and so on. So to organize the jumbled mess of ideas in my head, I use Google Sheets. So here is my legit organization method with Google Sheets. Oh, we're going behind the scenes now. So here's my content schedule so far for 2021. I've used Google Sheets to organize my topic ideas in one column, then any research notes or links that are helpful. Then I've got these color-coded published status right here too. And then finally, the day that it went live. So once I've locked in an idea, it's time for scripting. Yes, I script all of my videos. There's a few reasons for that, which I won't get into, but I use, obviously, Google Docs for scripting. This way, everything's organized in one place for me, so I can easily search for anything or make copies of scripts or edit right from there. And my scripting also includes all of my tags, video titles, description, every single thing. And I will touch on how I figure out my YouTube titles and tags in a minute, but first I want to talk about Google Calendar. I use GCal to keep my schedule organized with color blocking. So because YouTube isn't my full-time job yet, I've got a lot going on and I need to know at a quick glance what's coming up. So I have clients and tasks all organized per color in my GCal. And this includes things like my videos, when I'm scripting, when I'm shooting, and when they're going live. So rounding out pre-production are a couple of tools I use before I even start the scripting process. If you listen to anything in this video, let it be this. I literally script nothing unless I have an exact title locked in. So there are two tools I use to check for trending topics and keyword tags. First, I use trends.google.com. This is known as Google Trends, and I literally Google the popularity of a search term or word. And second, I use TubeBuddy. TubeBuddy is really great for both the pre-production and post-production ends of your videos. On the pre-production side, you can search within YouTube for specific keywords and titles that you're thinking of, and TubeBuddy will give you a keyword score to let you know if that's a topic that people are actually searching for. I'll talk more about TubeBuddy later on when we get into some post-production, and also I have a link below directly to TubeBuddy. So now let's talk shooting the video. There is a whole bunch of equipment I use and it is all linked below. So here we go. This is my exact YouTube setup and equipment list. So there are actually three different cameras I use to shoot my videos depending on what it is that I'm shooting. So my most used camera is actually this guy right here. This is the Sony ZV-1. And she's actually a little vlogging camera, but I find she's got some really great features and works perfectly for shooting in my small space. I actually purchased the camera with an accessory kit that came with a wireless Bluetooth tripod and an SD card. There are two things that I love the most about the Sony ZV-1. First, it's got really solid autofocus that doesn't jump around and refocus a lot, so it's not distracting. And second, with the push of a button, you can blur your background. This helps give the illusion of a greater depth of field, even when you're in a small space like I am. And the camera I use mostly for my business and for all of my YouTube B-roll is the Panasonic Lumix GH5. This is a more professional camera that's got slick 4K capabilities. Just keep in mind, you'll need to buy a lens with this one too. Lastly, when it comes to cameras, I use my iPhone 11 Pro when I quickly need another angle or if I'm grabbing a mobile screen recording. By the way, if you want to know what tripods I'm using for mobile devices, you can click right here or check out the best tech for 2021 video in the description below. So keep in mind, you don't have to start with the most expensive camera. Use what you have and make it work for you. Another thing you want to keep in mind when you're shooting on any type of camera, make sure you're using the right SD cards. I've linked to a bunch below, but buying the right card for your camera is crucial. And if you're finding this video valuable, remember to give it a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel for even more content like this. Now, moving on to audio. Audio is so important. And for my YouTube videos, I use the Rode VideoMic Pro Plus. This is a great compact directional shotgun mic that works both with a battery or plug-in power, which is really helpful if you're on the go and can't worry about charging another battery. Tripods and stands are also important because, duh, you have to set your camera up on something. So for this, I use the Vanguard Ulta Pro. I love this tripod and I think it's one of the best ones you can buy for your money. I actually have two of these exact models and I love the versatility. You can shoot from multiple angles with this guy and it's not really heavy, so it's definitely one you could travel with, yet it's sturdy and well built. I also use this desk mount stand for when I need to attach my ring light or microphone to my desk for certain video angles. It's a whopping $32 and lordy, is it ever handy. And speaking of lights, there are three different ones I use. First is this Neewer 18-inch ring light. This is typically my main light source as I don't have great natural light in here and I'm often shooting with this window behind me. Then I also have this Neewer tabletop USB light. So this guy's really handy, not only for any video calls I have, but I use it to fill in some shadows when I shoot my YouTube videos. And then I also have this Neewer dimmable camera video light. I use this guy to soften the harshness of the ring lights, and it's also nice and compact for shooting on the go if necessary. You may have also noticed these colored lights behind me. These guys are just battery powered wireless lights that you can either adhere to a surface or just move around like I do, freestanding. And they even come with this little handy remote so you can turn them on or off or change the colors without even having to get up. All of this equipment is linked for you below. So now let's talk about editing. And just to touch briefly on the equipment I use for editing. I've got a MacBook Pro, I use an Asus monitor as a second screen, and I've also got this Anchor docking station. This station is clutch in order for me to plug in the million things I have connected to my MacBook Pro. And speaking of things I have plugged into my Mac, I use a lot of external hard drives to store content, backup content, and just to work off of for my YouTube projects. Get yourself a great backup drive. And remember, I've linked to all the ones I use in the description below. So I get asked a lot what I use to capture my screen recordings when I'm making video tutorials for you guys. 99.9% of the time, I use Camtasia. And no, despite sharing a name with the company, I am not sponsored by them. Yet, 99% of the time, I use Camtasia for all of my screen recordings. But remember, use what you already have. Both Mac and Windows have built-in screen recording capabilities, so use that to your advantage. So for all my editing for YouTube, I use Final Cut Pro 10. It's the perfect prosumer editing suite, and it's so intuitive and easy to use. Obviously, there's a ton of built-in effects and transitions and features, but I actually like to step it up a notch by adding in third-party plugins and themes. So for that, I use FX Factory, Pixel Film Studios, and Leno FX in order to achieve really cool effects, text animations, reveals, and different transitions, and so much more. I even use these plugins to edit my audio if there's too much background noise or echo. I will only say this once, so pay attention. Plugins in Final Cut Pro are the way to step your videos up a notch. Trust me when I say, y'all know I am cheap, so I don't buy stuff just for the sake of buying stuff. It has to be worth it. So now let's get into the posting process and what happens after I actually post a YouTube video. So first let's talk about thumbnails and the importance of creating a thumbnail so you're not just using a random clip from your video. After I shoot my video, I actually record a little clip of me posing for what will be a still for my thumbnails. It sounds weird, I know, but I use a software called Wondershare Filmora to grab a high resolution snapshot from that clip. Now this snapshot is what will become my thumbnail with the help of Canva. I create all my thumbnails in Canva. I have the paid version, which allows me to remove the background from any image, which is really handy, but if you don't care about that, you can just get by just fine with the free version. I even create some of my social media promotional graphics in Canva as well. So if you remember from the way, way back, that was the beginning of this video, I mentioned I use TubeBuddy when I'm first creating my YouTube script and title and tag ideas. Well, I also use TubeBuddy on the back end when I'm actually posting the videos. With TubeBuddy, you can see suggested tags and how they're ranking, which is really helpful to adjust or add last minute tags to. Plus, I'll go back in after the video has been posted and check on how my tags are ranking, and I'll see if TubeBuddy suggests anything else for me. And if you want even more in-depth information on all the tools I use to shoot and edit my YouTube videos, I've created a free digital toolkit just for you, and I have linked to it in the description below. Listen, if you have made it to this point of the video, wow, I love you. And also, thank you for watching. And also, remember that I have all of the links listed for you, super organized in the description below. Happy video creating to you. So that's my complete YouTube setup and equipment list. What do you think of all the tools I use to shoot and edit my YouTube videos? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more of my favorite tech. See you next time.